Good morning, Whalers, and welcome to the WCPS Whaler News Network. My name is Isabel Horton.
And my name is Trevor Malloy. Today is a Friday, October 27th, and it's a day one. This broadcast is being brought to you by our good friends down at Stubby's. Located on the strip at 8 Broad Street, Stubby's has been serving breakfast, lunch, dinner, and late night food to the people of Nantucket since 2000. They have the most delicious food on the fly that you could possibly imagine. So whether it's the tasty egg sandwich in the morning, a classic burger for lunch, a healthy salad for dinner, or a nice Jamaican jerk chicken sandwich for that late night craving, you gotta go to Stubby's.
Let's start with a huge belated birthday shout-out to everyone's favorite PE teacher, Mr. Almodovar, who turned 21 years old on Wednesday. Sorry we missed you, Mr. Almodovar. And today, Anna Matos Martins and Ashlyn Santos Honorade are both celebrating, so have a great day, girls. For lunch today, our cafeteria will be serving up some classic cheese and pepperoni pizza. For weather, we will see a partly cloudy sky today with a high temperature of 66 degrees.
In sports on Wednesday, the CPS football team had their first home game and delivered a crushing blow to Mashpee. The boys played an outstanding game and outscored them with a final score of 42-6. Of course, don't forget, this is our homecoming weekend tomorrow morning. The boys football team will be taking on our arch rivals from Martha's Vineyard. The game will begin at 10:30 right here in Video Capizzo Stadium. So let's all show up to support our student athletes. There will also be an awesome pep rally tonight beginning at 6:30 right on the field, and then NHS homecoming parade tomorrow morning starts at 9 a.m. in town. In other sports news, we have now created what we are going to call the Battle in the Atlantic, in which our varsity boys and girls soccer and varsity field hockey teams will be playing for the coveted Golden Archer
anchor.
The winner of this game will keep the Golden Anchor for the next year, and it will be placed in a trophy case where all school and community members can see.
Save the date. The Batticular Fall Festival will take place this Sunday, October 29th from 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. at the Milestone Cranberry Bog with a bike race, food trucks, live music, and many more family fun activities. Also, on Tuesday, October 31st, join the annual Halloween Parade. Costumed adults and children are asked to arrive by 3:30 p.m. at the bottom of Main Street for the costume contest and parade. This will be followed by the party at the Whaling Museum for slightly spooky, super fun activities, and more trick-or-treating. Also, teachers, don't forget to get your tickets to Dreamland's annual Halloween party that will be Saturday. That will be Saturday night, October 28th, where Mr. G will be your celebrity mixologist.
That's me.
Now, we want to send shouts to Mrs. Gordon, the student council, and everyone who participated in our awesome Spirit Week so far. The winners are the following four celebrity. We had Robert Graves, Ben Potter, and Jade Francis. On our tourist day, Jack Fee and Ben Potter took home prizes. Then on Barbie Day, we saw Kaylee Flower, Billie Jean Kowser, and Anna Nikovala take first place. The twin winners were Jade and Jada, along with Robert Graves and Mrs. G. Finally, the Color Wars were won by the seventh graders, with Ben Potter and Chloe Washington leading the way. It all ends today with our Whaler Spirit Day as we get ready for an amazing homecoming weekend. Teachers, don't forget to sign up for the Nantucket Historical Association Mindful History Program. Mr. Davis will be teaching a yoga class this Saturday from 8:30 to 9:30 a.m. at the Greater Light at 8 Howard Street. This is a beautiful, historic Nantucket space that is ideal for yoga and other mindful practices. For more information, go to the NHA website.
Finally, today is National Black Cat Day. Don't be superstitious, but today we celebrate the beauty of these sleek creatures. The day also seeks to raise awareness about the low adoption rates for black cats. This time of year, many black cats may decorate many thresholds for Halloween and windows for spooky decor. However, these felines deserve the love and attention just as much as their tabby equivalents. Old notions have given these furry critters a bad reputation. This day is about turning that reputation around.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, that's all the news for today. Have a great weekend, take care of yourselves and each other, and most importantly,
be kind to one another!
Bye!